This is the editorial to your broadcasting from Canada, and I welcome you to it once again. My name is Sandra Asante. Today we'll be looking at Tigray's conflict, the need for food, and the verge of starvation to death. So stay tuned, I'll be back after the break. You're welcome back from the break. Thank you so much for always staying with me. People in the district of Ethiopia's Tigray region have told BBC they are on a verge of starvation. "We don't have anything to eat," a man in Kafta Himera said, saying their crops and livestock have been looted during the 7 months of war. He added that they were being prevented from seeking aid by a militia fighting. The testimony comes as UN Chief Antonio Guterres had warned that parts of Tigray are on the brink of famine. A conflict erupted in November, forcing close to 2 million people from their homes in Tigray, a region that was already food insecure. The Ethiopian authorities insist that order is now being restored across the region and humanitarian access expanded. But last week, the UN warned of a repeat of Ethiopia's devastating 1984 famine and called for an immediate ceasefire in Tigray. Now let's look at how the condition is like in all this. The dire and frightening, according to people living in Kafta Himera, a district in the west of Tigray that is close to the border of Sudan and Eritrea, who were contracted by the BBC Tigrayan service via phone. Since November 2020, the Western Tigray zone has been occupied by pro-government forces and militias from the neighboring region of Amhara. We are civilians, our crops and cattle have been taken by the armed men, one farmer in his 60s said. "They took from me around 30 cows and oxen. There are some who lost 100 to 200 head of cattle." Another farmer in his 40s told the BBC, "We were eating small remains of crops left from our bandits, but now we don't have anything. Nobody has given us any aid. Almost everyone is on the verge of death. Our eyes are affected by the hunger. The situation is perilous. Death is knocking on our door. You can see the hunger on the face of each of us." Residents say they have seen vehicles carrying aid pass by, but no one had bothered to inquire about their predicament. So right now, I just want us to look at the reasons why all this is going on, but residents aren't fleeing. The older farmer said people have been trying to travel somewhere, like towns of Shire and Shiraro, about 200 kilometers, that is 125 miles east of their district, to find food and humanitarian supplies. But transport has been difficult to come by, and those that have vehicles have been prevented from leaving the area by the militia. "When we want to go to the place where there is aid, all roads are blocked," he said, adding that those who have tried to flee on foot have been asked to pay bribes, which they cannot afford. "Even if you try on foot, if the militias from Amhara finds us, they force us to pay 4,000 to 5,000 birr, between 90 to 115 US dollars each. The younger farmer added that people feared being killed if they come face to face with the militia in the bush. "If you try to go to the place where there is aid, we will be killed in the forest," he stated. This is quite sad, but right now let's draw concerns on how the response has been concerning others. A local administrator appointed for the area in the wake of the conflict told the BBC that no federal aid was available and only limited assistance was coming through the neighboring Amhara. Mr. Guterres warned the situation will only keep getting worse unless funding was increased and humanitarian access was improved. The government says international humanitarian workers have been allowed in most part of Tigray. Months after the conflict began, many critical services have not been fully restored. Dozens of health centers and hospitals have been destroyed or looted. Why is there a war all the time in Tigray? The war erupted when Ethiopia's government launched an offensive to oust the ruling then party, the Tigray People's Liberation Front, the TPLF. The party had had a massive fallout with Prime Minister Abiy over political changes to the country's ethnically based federal system, though the TPLF's capture of federal military bases in Tigray was a catalyst for the invasion. Mr. Abiy, the Nobel Prize winner, declared that conflict was over at the end of November, but fighting has continued. Thousands of people have been killed. About 1.7 million have fled their homes. Tens of thousands have sought refuge in neighboring Sudan. The conflict has also involved troops from neighboring Eritrea fighting with the government. All sides have been accused of numerous human rights abuses. Thank you so much for watching today's edition of Editorials. My name is Sandra Asante. I'll see you some other time.